Servus and welcome to the Audi Digital Summer Tour Studio. I'm Kati, your host, and every single day we are trying to connect you at home, wherever that may be, to your favorite FC Bayern stars and our FC Bayern family all over the world. Just in case you have missed any of the content we've provided you with so far, don't worry, you can find it on the FC Bayern YouTube channel in full length. And if you want to take part in this tour, please do so and use the hashtag AudiFCBTour. You can ask questions to our guests, to the players, of course, and we will try to help you out and communicate with you as much as possible. Today, you are in for a real treat. We have a video clip of Manuel Neuer connecting with the Mexican national team goalie, former Mexican national team goalie Guillermo Ochoa, and we also will talk to Chris Richards from the second team here in a second. But most importantly, I have a very, very nice studio guest for you guys today. On November 15th, 2019, he stepped into the footsteps of a certain Mr. Uli Hoeneß, not knowing that he will be facing probably one of the most outstanding challenges that society had to face in the past 10 years or so, but he did an outstanding job, and he's with me today, the president of FC Bayern Munich, Herbert Hainer. Welcome.
Hello, thanks for having me here.
Thanks for taking the time. It has been quite challenging. That's why the first team, of course, right now was not able to go on the Audi Summer Tour to China as planned. But we are trying to do it in a digital way for the first time ever. What are your impressions and what is are your thoughts on this way of doing it?
Good. Unfortunately, as you said, we were not able to travel this year. And this is a pity because one of our key priorities is to be very close to our fans all around the world, of course here in Munich, but also to our fans who have not the chance to come to the Allianz Arena and see us live on the pitch. And therefore, we had the idea, if we can't travel, we still want to be talk to our fans, be in connection with our fans and be close. And our team came up with the idea of the so-called digital summer tour. And all what I have heard and seen so far is very successful and is very appreciated by the fans around the world. And therefore, we are happy that we have the opportunity and the chance to talk to the fans.
Mm-hmm. The former president, Uli Hoeneß, he's a very good friend of yours, and he was always known as a man of the people. Is that something that you really wanted to continue as well as the FC Bayern president?
As a first and foremost, I have to say that I think this is one of the key things why the FC Bayern is so loved by millions of fans around the world, because we are not only successful on the pitch, but we also take care about the people around the world, and especially people who need our help. So we have a certain responsibility for the society, and especially Uli Hoeneß was the one who did this in an extreme positive and helpful way. And to be honest, if I wouldn't be of the same character, he would never have proposed me to be his successor. So yes, this is definitely on my agenda as well.
Mm-hmm. Now, as the president of the club, how important do you think is the direct contact with the fans, and have you had any of it or any experiences that you can tell us about with the fans directly?
I do believe that the contact with our fans is one of the most important things, because first and foremost, the fans pay our bill, because they go to the stadiums, they buy the tickets, they buy our shirts, etc. And the second point is that in being close to the fans, we hear their comments, what they are thinking about the club, what we do well, but where we also can improve. And this is quite important. And before I became president here of Bayern Munich, I should mention that I was the last 18 years in the supervisory board of Bayern Munich. So I know the club very well. But before I got elected as a president, I went out to certain fans groups and talk to the members and told them what I do believe should be done in the future. Mm-hmm. And what their questions are and what their remarks and their advices are, just to understand whether my agenda is close to the agenda of the fans. Mm-hmm. So I definitely do believe that this is a very important point.
Mm-hmm. Here in Bayern, of course, everybody knows Mir San Mir and kind of what it means. But maybe you can tell us, especially for the fans worldwide, what does Mir San Mir really mean?
I mean, there is no precise description, but this is a feeling which we have here. And this feeling is, on the one hand, that we are self-confident, but not arrogant. That we are always believe in ourselves, that we always fight until the last second to be able to win, that we never give up, and that we always believe in ourselves. And this is the so-called description of Mir San Mir.
Mm-hmm. We talked about that this show is also going on for the Chinese market in China every single day. And of course, the Chinese market is very interesting for FC Bayern. Why do you think is China such a huge market for FC Bayern with so much potential? And why do we have so many loyal supporters like on the other side of the world?
Good. Obviously, I know the Chinese market very well because in my tenure as the Adidas CEO, I was at least, I would say, 50 times in China. And China is one of the biggest markets for Adidas as well. So we have 1.5 billion people. There are a lot of sport enthusiasts in China. And they are very football oriented. But unfortunately, the Chinese Football League is not as good as the European. And therefore, a lot of fans looking to the European top clubs. And as Bayern is one of the top clubs in China, they are looking to Bayern Munich, of course. The second point is that we opened an office in Shanghai four mm-hmm. years ago to stay closer to the fans, to give more service to the fans in China, to be more in connection and make sure that they understand what the FC Bayern is, how our players are acting, what they're thinking, and so giving them a kind of feeling that they are closer to our players, to the club. And this, I think, is the secret of success.
Mm-hmm. Of course, the players are back in full practice. Let's talk about sports a little bit. Tomorrow, first test match against Olympique Marseille. What are your first impressions of the team?
Good. I saw the team training in the last 2 days, and I had the chance just by incident that I ran on the hallway into the coach and we talked for 10 minutes and he told me that the players are extremely focused, mm-hmm. they train really well, full engagement, and they are all looking forward to the games for the Champions League because they have won already two titles, and this is the once in a lifetime for many players a chance to win the triple, which means the German Championship, the Cup, and the Champions League. And they definitely know that they are able to do it because they play so well the last 3-4 months since the restart of the Corona crisis. They're extremely focused, and I do believe we have a very good chance.
That's good. If you have a good feeling, we all have a good feeling about it. We have a goal voting going on this week, and we are already in the semi-finals. Yesterday, we had Arjen Robben versus Manchester United and Robert Lewandowski versus FC Barcelona. Now, the question is, who will make it to the final? And here's your answer. That's so funny. You know what Herbert Hainer just said? It was a very bad job of the defender. Yeah. Tell us again, what did he do?
First and foremost, I have to say it was a fantastic goal from Arjen Robben. But the defender, as you can see, turned away and wanted to show Arjen the back. And therefore, Arjen had the chance to pass the ball by and kicked it into the goal.
As easy as that. Arjen Robben, he's a very often seen opponent in our goal voting, but we need somebody to go up against him in the final. And now we're looking at semi-final number two. Here's your matchup. he is again. Arjen Robben versus David Alaba. And maybe we have a final of two Robben goals. We'll see. Which one did you like better, Mr. Hainer?
I think they were both very important goals. Arjen's goal was in the Champions League final at the Wembley Stadium. I was in the stadium. And the other one was from David Alaba against Juve. So let the fans decide which one they like the best.
Exactly. Let the fans decide. Very good. You can vote now on either the FC Bayern Twitter or the Instagram Stories channel. Please vote using the hashtag AudiFCBTour. And then tomorrow we will go into the finals. Okay, it's time to have our next virtual live guest on the show. He's been waiting for us to talk to him. He actually is a part of the FC Bayern Amateure, which is the second team, as you know, of course. And he came to the FC Bayern family in 2018 from FC Dallas, which is a partner club of FC Bayern.
Yes, correct.
He's done a very good job so far. Welcome, Chris Richards. Can you hear us?
Yes, I can hear you perfectly.
Okay. So you just returned from a short holiday break, I've heard. Were you able to recharge your batteries a little bit?
Yes, I was. It was really nice to be able to see my family and some of my friends and just have a little pause and get my legs back under me.
So just tell us, what does it mean to you to wear the FC Bayern jersey?
It means everything to me. Not very many Americans get to wear it, and not many people around the world get to wear it. And there's a rich culture and rich history behind the jersey, and it's a real honor to wear it.
What do you think is so special about this club, especially now that you're a part of it? Maybe you can say a little bit better.
I think it's really the family aspect of this club, you know, whether it's from the whole academy or it's the Amateur de Mannschaft or the Profis, it's all just one big family, and we all want to see each other succeed. So however we can do that, we do it.
Okay. So I was asking earlier, because we showed a couple of your goals, do you ever use your foot to score goals or just your head?
Usually it's just my head. Not very often do I score with my feet.
Fair enough.
But so I hope he's using his feet in the future as well.
Did you hear? Yes, you can also use your feet.
That's true.
You did spend a lot of time, of course, at the FC Bayern state-of-the-art youth academy. It's called the FC Bayern campus. Maybe you can let our FC Bayern family all over the world know a little bit more about that.
Yeah, so the FC Bayern campus, it houses a lot of us academy kids, whether it's from, I believe, U12 all the way up to U19. And, you know, there's a lot of kids in there. They feel like little brothers and big brothers. And it's a really welcoming, environment. And it's the start of a pro environment at a young age. And it was really good for me. And it's really good for the academy kids as well.
Mm-hmm. Do you think this academy is also one of the main reasons why a lot of young players are part of the first team rosters as well?
Yes, I definitely think it's a main reason. Like I said, it's exposing us to a professional environment at a very young age, and it's 24/7 football, and it's just getting us ready for the next step every year that you graduate in the academy. And then once you get to the amateur team, then it wants to get you ready for the profi team. But you've learned all this throughout living at the campus.
Mm-hmm. Let's talk about sports a little bit and the first team. Tomorrow is the first test against Olympique Marseille. How important do you think is the test, especially regarding the preparation for the Champions League, of course?
I think it's a really good test for the team. You know, they just came back from a break, and, you know, training is always good, but sometimes you need to see yourself against a different opposition. And they're also a very good team. So it's going to be a really good test to see how ready we are for the Champions League.
Mm-hmm. You already had a chance to make your experiences with the first team. What are your chances, do you think, of being a permanent member maybe in the near future?
Honestly, it's all up to me. You know, if I give 100% every day and I just keep working hard, hopefully the staff will reward me with a spot on the team. And then from there, it's just keep working and hopefully try to get more minutes.
Mm-hmm. We actually got a fan tweet regarding exactly that. What was it like for you to train with the first team? What was it like to train with Robert Lewandowski and the rest, of course? And do you maybe have a role model on the team?
So training with the first team, it's really, it was very crazy at first. You know, like you said, there's Lewandowski. When I started off here, there was Frank Ribery, Ayn Robin. And these are guys who are legends, not just at Bayern, but around the world. And me coming from Dallas, it was really shocking at first because I didn't think I had any right to be there. And, I was a little starstruck at first, but once I got moving, I realized that, you know, I have to hold my own. And so, it's always a challenge with the first team, but it only makes you better. And one person that I really look up to on the team is David Alaba. Mm-hmm. He's kind of been a role model for me. You know, he sometimes talks to me off the field, whether it's just, you know, how I'm feeling and here in Munich. And he's come up through the academy and he's played pretty much his whole career here at Bayern, and he's a legend. And so he's definitely somebody who I look up to.
Okay.
Chris, let me tell you, I saw you practicing with the first team from my office window, and it looked very good. So keep on going. And by the way, if you look up to David Alaba, you know that he is using his left foot very often to score.
So you must know he's always watching. This is what he's saying. Okay. And how did it feel to play your first Bundesliga minutes? Tell us a little bit about that.
Oh, wow. It was definitely a dream come true, not only for me, but for my family as well. You know, it's something I dreamed of ever since coming to Bayern, and me being able to play in Allianz Arena and in front of a lot of people who I've looked up to my whole life. It was really an amazing honor for me.
Awesome. Apart from the sports side, we got a fan tweet asking, how do you like Munich, and what do you think is the biggest difference between Europe and the US?
Yeah, I love Munich, actually. It's a really nice city, historic city. It's very beautiful. I think that one of the main differences is the winters here. Back home in the US, I grew up in Alabama and in Texas, and the winters would get cold, but you wouldn't see very much snow. But here in Munich, during wintertime, it snows a lot. And that was something I really had to get used to, driving in the snow and training in the snow. That's probably the biggest difference for me.
Okay. Thank you, Chris. It's nice talking to you. And hopefully, once you start using your left foot, you can be a part of the first team roster. We shall see. All the best to you. All the best for the season. And hopefully we'll see you again soon out on the pitch.
Hopefully.
Take care. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Good guy. Seems like a very good guy. We have someone really special right now. Did you know where the biggest fan club outside of Germany is? The biggest FC Bayern fan club.
Is it in Mexico?
Is it in Mexico.
Guadalajara?
Yes, it is.
Oh,
and
okay.
Do you know how many members it has?
No.
It has more than 5,000. More than 5,000 members.
Oh, wow.
How that happened, we will ask the chairman himself. I hope he can hear us. Gerald Fiedler is with us today. Can you hear us?
Yes.
Yes.
Hello.
Maybe a little bit. Okay. So Gerald Fiedler, first of all, does not sound like the typical Mexican name. Can you tell us where you're originally from?
Yeah, I'm a native Bavarian. I was born in Nuremberg.
Grew Franconian.
Up in Herzogenaurach, close to Herzogenaurach. Mr. Hainer knows it.
Okay. Then, let us hear a little bit of your Franconian accent.
Afterwards, I lived some years in Munich. And since 2010, I'm working and living here in Mexico.
Okay.
In Guadalajara.
And for us, you know, maybe it sounds surprising that there are so many FC Bayern fans in Mexico. Are there a lot generally, or just your fan club?
The difference is generally the people are very passionate for the football, obviously, in Mexico and Latin America. They are breathing soccer 24/7 every day. We have discussions, and it's quite different to Germany. And when I come here to Mexico, it was a little bit strange because the big broadcasters, nobody was very really interested in the German football. So in the last years, this situation changed a little bit, and now we have the Bundesliga and obviously FC Bayern on the big broadcasters. But at the beginning, it was terrible. So everybody was speaking only about the Spanish league and the Premier League, and it was quite frustrating for me to see that. And I thought I have to change that. I have to do a missionary job here to obtain some fans and members for the fan club. So I was in contact with Raimund Aumann and his team, and they gave me the green light to go ahead. And well, now we are working here 10 years.
Okay, tell us a little bit about that fan club. More than 5,000 members. What do you guys do on a regular basis?
Well, as I mentioned before, the fan club was founded in 2010. We are based in Guadalajara, but it's... we are operating nationwide, so the members are all across Mexico, not only in Guadalajara. Actually, we have more than 4,000 members and more than 400,000 followers over all social media platforms. And the commitment was or is to promote FC Bayern here in Mexico through the social media 24/7, as well as the players, the legend, the culture, and everything related with Bavaria and FC Bayern. We are not able to organize for every single game a watch party or every weekend a watch party because of the fact that the members are across the country, and it's very difficult to organize it in 20 or more cities, no? But for special matches or our anniversaries, every year we organize watch parties and bars, or we come together in different cities, which we have organized with... we see the matches at the cinema, which is very, very unique for this club, for example. To get the people in at the cinemas across the country, it's a great thing. And another commitment for the fan club, and especially for me, is the social or charity project, which we help homeless people, children, refugees from Central America, and old people. Mm-hmm. That's what we are basically doing here in Mexico.
Very nice. That sounds very nice. So you're lucky because we have President Herbert Hainer with us today. So if you have a question, maybe now is a good time to ask.
Yeah. Servus, Herr Hainer.
Hello. Grüß Sie, Herr Fiedler.
Do you think once the pandemic situation is under control, do you think it's possible to see you and the team one day in Mexico or Latin America?
I mean, I definitely know out of my experience in Adidas how big the fan basis in Latin America is for football. And I personally signed the first contract 15 years ago with the Mexican national team, so I know how passionate the Mexicans are for football. And we definitely want to connect with our fans all over the world. And so far, we do it through personal trips to America and to China. But Latin America is definitely an important part of our fan bases. So be it Mexico, be it Brazil or Argentina. And I definitely can imagine that we one day will go over to Mexico, no doubt. And especially when we have such great supporters like you who are taking care about our fans in this country, this definitely is possible, yeah.
Okay.
Georg, we will let you know in advance.
Gerald, Fiedler. Okay, thank you so much for joining us in the studio. Continue with the great work you are doing over there, and hopefully our team will get a chance to do the Audi Summer Tour in Mexico sooner than later. All the best.
Okay. Thank you. Thanks for having me.
Cheers.
Okay, Mr. Hainer, you said you did personally the contract with the Mexican national team a long time ago. Do you maybe know someone by the name Moises Munoz? He was one of the national team goalies
a while ago.
That's a good question. I'm not sure, but today he's a journalist and he actually had a talk with Manuel Neuer and with Guillermo Ochoa, who of course is also a very
former goalie.
Exactly. And they talked to each other and here's what they talked about. We have a video of that.
I am really happy to be here with Guillermo Ochoa, America's legend goalkeeper, and Manuel Neuer, a legend also of the FC Bayern and the German national soccer team. So thank you for being with us. It's a very, very good time today to be with the two of the top best goalkeepers. How are you guys doing, Memo?
Hi, Moy. Hi, Manuel. I'm happy to be here with you, to see you again. And of course, happy to be with all the people who have the opportunity to watch this this video, this interview.
Manuel, how are you doing? How's everything?
Yeah, hi, Memo. Nice to meet you again, to see you. And I'm very happy to have this little conversation and video to talk about everything. And I'm very well. We are preparing for the next step in our Champions League. And I'm feeling good.
Well, there is 201 men's national team games played between you two. I mean, we add up 201 games with the national team, 7 World Cup appearances. That's a lot. There has been 17 club titles adding up between you two, and one of you has already won a World Cup. Let's start off with a couple of questions that I have with you here today. And I want to ask both of you, let's start off with Manuel. What are the main attributes that you believe a goalkeeper must have to achieve success?
Yeah, the first thing is you have to be fun what you're doing. You want to be a goalkeeper, so you have to practice, you have to try hard day by day. And if you have fun, if you are happy to go into the goal, you become better. And that's the main thing. That you can practice every day with your friends, with your teammates, and you can get better day by day.
You can watch the full-length video on the FC Bayern YouTube channel, just as well as any other video that we've shown you on this Audi Digital Summer Tour. And of course, this show. Tomorrow is match day, FC Bayern versus Olympique Marseille. And afterwards, we will be back here in the studio with the first statements, with the highlights of the game. So please don't miss it. We will also have Joshua Kimmich versus Leon Goretzka in the agility challenge. We will have Thomas Müller and Robert Lewandowski talking to some Chinese athletes. And of course, we will have a Bayern legend here tomorrow again. Well, virtually here tomorrow again. Vicente Lizarazu will talk to us tomorrow. Don't miss it. If you have questions, please ask them. Use the hashtag AudiFCBTour and the hashtag MiaSanFamily. And right after this show today, please head over to our friends from ESPN on Instagram, because Alexis Nunes will talk to Robert Lewandowski on Instagram Live 7:30 Central Eastern European time or something like that. You can check it out right now. ESPN Instagram Live, Robert Lewandowski. And I think we have earned the best part of Bavaria, which is the beer, of course.
Very good.
Thank you so much for keeping me company today, although your schedule, I'm sure, is really tight. Albert.
Was a pleasure, and I'm looking forward to a good Palana Weizenbier.
Yes.
Here we go. Thanks very much.
Cheers. Thank you.
Welcome.
Prost. Prost. See you tomorrow.